Hi, Jay here from Fireless Fitness. What I'm going to be showing you today is how to perform a kettlebell swing. Now, there's a lot of confusion about what's right and wrong when it comes to this movement, but essentially it boils down to the fact, what we are trying to achieve with a kettlebell swing. Yeah, and we're trying to work an explosive extension of hips using the muscles of the posterior chain, i.e. the hamstrings, the glutes, and the muscles of the back. Yeah, specifically the glutes should be the driving force in that hip extension. The first thing we have to do before we go into a kettlebell swing with weight, i.e. under load, is make sure we can achieve a comfortable hinge of the hips, yeah, whilst keeping the spine in neutrality. Yeah, so all the vertebrae sitting on top of the intervertebral disc, yeah, with no pressure on either side, there's no torsion, yeah, there's no flexion or extension of the spine. It's simply an opening and a closing of the hips, yeah, just like we would do with a door on its hinge. From there, a second thing to note when it comes to the kettlebell swing is essentially just like when we do the deadlift, we want the hamstrings to be high. We don't want to be squatting into the movement because that's just going to transfer the load onto the quads, i.e. the thighs. Yeah, these quadricep muscles work to extend the knee. Yeah, so during the squat, yes, we're working the posterior chain, the hamstrings, the glutes, the muscles of the back too. However, it's them quads that are really working to extend the knee. So what we see a lot of the time when people work a kettlebell swing is they do this sort of squatting type swing, and all that's happening is they're not loading that posterior chain to the fullest extent, they're simply loading the quads, yeah, taking away sort of the potential we can develop from the movement working with a much straighter leg position. That's not to say that we're going to lock the knees out, yeah, during that sort of swing back, so we get that back swing, the kettlebells between the legs. It just means we're going to take a soft knee position, yeah, a slight bend in the knees, yeah, just to take any unnecessary stress off them. Yeah, so as we swing rearwards, yeah, we're going to have a slight bend in the knees. We're going to pop them hips into extension, working the hamstrings, the glutes, the muscles of the back, the erector spine, and we're going to bring that kettlebell up to chest height. Yeah, the knees will lock out at this point, and we'll be squeezing them glutes hard, really trying to get as much activation from the musculature as possible. Yeah, so now I'm going to show you how we work it using the kettlebell. Yeah, just point to note, we said that we'd bring it to chest height. The reason for that is by the time it's come to chest height, we've achieved our aim. We've achieved full extension hips. Taking it up overhead is just going to increase the risk of shoulder injuries, and you're not going to be achieving much more. Yeah, you might say, oh, it's better for the core, it works the shoulders, it looks good. We're trying to achieve explosive extension of hips. Yeah, the most important movement, in my opinion, for any athlete. Yeah, athletic progression, yeah, increase their ability to explode into hip extension. Olympic lifters, football players, runners, boxers, MMA fighters, all need explosive hip extension. Yeah, so what we're going to do, we're going to step rearwards with the kettlebell. We're going to ground the kettlebell quite far away, yeah, which is just going to allow us to get a good backswing and break straight into the movement. A second way that we can do it is we can stand up, take a small swing, just to unload the hips, and then go from there. Yeah, so we're going to turn the first method. We're going to grab the kettlebell. Yeah, we're going to get a nice, good backswing and explode there, yeah, into chest height. So we get a nice hinge of the hips and just explode up to that chest height. Yeah, the kettlebell is quite easily surpassing that height. Then that just says that we can go a little bit heavier. It all depends on your goals. Whether you're working strength, you're trying to build that power, or you're working a little bit more endurance, you want to do them higher rep ranges, you're going to go a little bit lighter. Yeah, so there we go. That's the basics of the kettlebell swing. Yeah, essentially, keep a soft knee bend through the back swing and explode into hip extension. The goal is explosive extension of the hips, utilizing the posterior chain, not utilizing a knee bend where we're just working the swing.